In this video, I show you how to add text to your videos in Shotcut. Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're going to look at adding text to videos in Shotcut. There are two main ways to add text to videos in Shotcut. The first is to apply the text to the video clip itself, and that's done by cutting the video in the correct place and then applying the text filter to the video clip that's been cut. This limits the text to only that section of the video. If I demonstrate that now, no text, and then the text comes up, and then where it cuts, it will disappear again. The second method is to apply the text to its own channel in your video timeline. To do this, you create the new channel and then add a transparent layer and then add your text to that layer. The end result is very similar to the first, but this allows you to add your text over multiple tracks or over multiple video cuts. So both methods are very valid, and you're probably going to need to use a mixture of the two during your Shotcut editing. So the first thing I'm going to do for method one, which is applying the text to a video clip, is drag in the first video clip and then scroll to the place where you want your text to begin. Cut the video with this button here, or S on the keyboard. And then where you want the text to end, do the same again. So now you can select the part of the video that you want your text to display on. Select that part and then come up to filters, click the plus, under the video tab, select or search for text. Under text, you have two options. You want the text simple option. And then on your video timeline, if you click into, so your playhead is over that section, you will see that you've got your text to display on the screen. Running through these options very quickly, the presets are something that you should always select first. If you select it after doing something down here, then it's going to overwrite anything you've done. So what you want to do is you select your preset first. This can be particularly helpful if you want something like a lower third selection, but generally speaking, you're probably going to manually do this yourself. So the next box is about the text that you're actually going to show on the screen. It's got some handy insert fields just down here that you can use for certain things. You're welcome to use them if you need to, but in most cases, I think you're probably going to overtype this and type in your own things. So for this example, I'm going to put in, this is a bike, and I'll use an exclamation mark, and that's going to be my text that I want on the screen. Coming down, you've got your font color, your font type, and if you click into that, then you can change it to pretty much anything you want. You've got this option here. Now, if you don't have this selected, your boundary box is going to automatically resize your font as you move it around the screen. However, if you have this selected, it's going to make it look very different, and the reason for that is that we've got size 48 selected here, so it's going to use the size option in this box here. So if you don't want to use a set size and you want it to resize to your boundary box, I suggest unticking this and using your boundary box as the sizing mechanism. In Shotcut, the outline of your text always has a color as well, so you can add or decrease the size of that with the thickness here and the color here. And just for reference, if you click onto any of these, you can use a color picking tool just to select the color that you want, the gradient that you want there, and also you've got your alpha channel here. 255 is full color, and then 0 is transparent. So depending on what you want and which one you're on, you may want different things to happen there. So you could theoretically have your font as being completely transparent just with an outline, and then that would make a pretty weird effect, but that might be what you're after. As you move down, your size and position, if you want to be exact on measurements on the screen, then you can do that. Me personally, I use these boundary boxes, so by using the boundary box and resizing it to exactly where you want, then that gives you exactly the same effect as trying to play with all of these numbers. Now, if you want to completely move your text, so you want it right at the very top of the screen, you could be using these, having it aligned to the left or right. This, as this is completely full size, it's not going to show you much, but the obviously the top, middle and bottom vertical fits do. You've also got the option of moving the boundary box to exactly where you want it. So by clicking on this circle in the center, you can change it to exactly where you want it to be. Okay, so I'm just going to click down here on the video track one, which is going to deselect everything, and that gets rid of the boundary box option. And then I'm just going to click play on the video just to show you that it pops up here, and then it will disappear again here. Okay, so if you wanted to add text to your video and you've not got any kind of editing going on throughout this, then that's probably the easiest way and the quickest way for you to add text to your videos. Now, option two is when you have standalone text that isn't connected to your video in any way. So first of all, if we add in a second video track and then just start playing that, you can see it's got no text on it and it's just going to play a little bit of chess on the screen there. What we want is an overlay to have text over the top, but what we don't want to do is have it connected to the video itself. First thing we need to do, click on to open other, click on to text, and then you can type your text in here or just leave it blank and click OK. When this screen pops up, just close it down and go to your playlist section. Drag your screen over to the playlist and then let go. Here it will say transparent, and basically what we've done there is created a text filter with a transparent background. So now if we want to apply the same text again and again and again to a video, then we can double click on here, get it selected in red. We can make our edits in the filters section. So it says this is chess. And then when you drag that onto the timeline, it will always have exactly the right settings that you've put into your filter here. Now, if you wanted to change that for any reason on your timeline, you can change it here, and let's change that to 6, and let's put an exclamation mark on the end, and let's not use the font. So this is much bigger, this is kind of similar to this, but the template file, if we go back to the template file, it's still going to be small and unaffected. So you can always use a template file up here and reuse the same text, or you can edit it on the fly down here. A little bit more versatile than this option, than the first option. Okay, so with this transparent layer added into our timeline, we can extend that to the full video if we wanted to, or we can have it display to the point where we want it to stop. So it can have a very similar effect to this, where it starts playing and then it pops up, and then as soon as it finishes, it disappears again. Exactly the same result as that. So why would we want to do this method? Well, let's imagine that for whatever reason we wanted the text to display half over this one and half over that one. Then we can do that with a transparent layer. You couldn't do that with method one, so therefore you'd need to use method two. This also allows us to do transitions between the two without it affecting the text. So now they'll filter into each other, but the text has not changed. So as you go through your editing journey, I expect you'll need both of these options at different times. The key is to understanding when to use each one, and I would advise when possible to use option one and when not possible to use option two. Option two takes a little bit longer, but it is a little bit more versatile. I hope that's been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.